Good morning, everybody. Welcome in. It's Laura from Tenacious, Taurus Twin Flame Tarot, and this is going to be the general daily collective message for Monday, October the 17th. Keep in mind, timing and energy is still fluid. This message could play out today or over the next several days. This message may or may not be for you. So I do ask that you only take with you the messages that resonate and leave behind the rest. We are in store for some very intense energies building and leading up into the solar eclipse, the new moon in Scorpio. And so today we do have a transit between Mars and the Sun. There's a trine aspect, and so this is really stimulating our vitality. I also feel this competitiveness in the energy, and so I feel get ready to find your confidence when it comes to overcoming any obstacles that you've needed to face recently when it comes to maybe making some necessary changes. I feel there's going to be an opportunity to take charge of a situation in the energies, and I feel it is about taking responsibility, facing these challenges that maybe you didn't want to look at before, finding the strength to do that, because you're going to be brave and courageous when it comes to taking initiative. So I feel some tackling demanding energies in the energy. I also feel maybe this is going to drive somebody forward when it comes to trying to impress somebody, especially when it comes to your romantic life. So you're going to want to be mindful, though, because the moon is forming a square with Mercury, and so your mood is likely going to be very opinionated, and you might find yourself offending people. So I do feel this strong urge to take action, though. I think a lot of energy is coming forward when it comes to what is needing to be done, when it comes to your conscious awareness. And it is like this primal desire surfacing. And so I also feel this energy of like a sudden perspective shift, especially with the moon forming a square to Mercury, because the moon is all about our emotions, and Mercury is all about communications. And so I feel like maybe even an epiphany, an aha moment, something that's going to be the source of this change, of this outlook shift in perspective. So this can come from many places. It might be as simple as a conversation with somebody, or engaging in maybe scrolling on social media, or this might even come through a movie or music, something of the sort. So just be aware of that. But I do feel hidden desires, hidden emotions coming to the surface as part of these energies today. So let's jump in with some cards, guys. Let's see what other energies need to come through. Kitty is all over me right now, so I'm not sure what's up with that. I think we are going to start off today using the Star Codes Astro Oracle deck. I just saw the Midhaven, so it's a fated house. The 10th house is fated. It's also linked to our purpose. So we're going to get a few messages with this deck first. A huge pile just come out, and we get the 12th house. So the 12th house is a very karmic house. It is also the house that knows no bounds. It is also the house of where we bury the past and deal with all of this past karmic baggage. And so maybe there's a need to close out a major cycle, to bury the past. Maybe there's been a Kundalini activation, or there's going to be a Kundalini activation. I think somebody's really, really thinking about a committed partnership. Kitty, you need to go. Sorry, guys. Committed partnership, Pallas Athena. And so I always think of like really thinking about what it is that you want to manifest in your love life, and maybe who you want to collaborate with. So Aquarius is the water bearer. So there might be a very emotional conversation coming, and you might have to sit and digest this information. I feel harvest energy. The time is now to bring a situation to the surface, something that maybe you've been thinking about for a long time. Collaboration. This could be one-on-one collaborations. This could be a business deal. This could be a romantic partnership. This could be a whole social circle of some sort. But I feel there's going to be a conversation. You're going to have to go into introspection. You're really going to have to sit and digest this. Virgo is a six. So this is going to allow you to journey towards balance and harmony. Virgo always likes perfection too. Virgo is the sign of service. And so maybe this collaboration is going to lead you into a partnership for your service-based mission. And then we get the asteroid Ceres, along with the Taurus energy cultivate. And so we are heading towards that eclipse energy. And then we're gonna have the full moon eclipse in Taurus. And so right now we're in this big energy of purging, allowing things to be eclipsed out of our lives so we can nurture what it is we want to grow, what it is we want to cultivate for a foundation. And so definitely a lot of deep inner turmoil when it comes to maybe a relationship cycle. The seventh house is all about relationships. It's all about our codependencies and karmic entanglements too. And so maybe there is a karmic entanglement here where it's getting quite tense. It's getting very discomforting, very uncomfortable, and the energy is demanding change. Big time changes. Uranus comes in to shake things up, right? And Uranus is in Taurus, and Taurus is all about the tangible. So this could be like a financial foundation getting upheaved, but this is going to move somebody straight towards a beloved connection. The Venus energy, and right now Venus is in Libra, very balanced, very grounded, and Libra is all about equality, right? And I feel something about the home. So you might want to have a look at your fourth house. This is your deep family roots. And is this what you've envisioned for your life? There's something that needs to be digested. And there is going to be a need to maybe think about who you've been collaborating with and maybe realign with certain people. Or maybe this is stemming around a job. But I think you're really going to have to sit in this energy, think about it. Nurture yourself, go through a period of growth and expansion, and maybe clearing some past karma. The 12th house is also a very spiritual house. There is a link to the Taurus North Node with this energy. So you could be dealing with an Aquarius, a Virgo, or a Taurus. But there is a foundation that is being reevaluated, is what I'm feeling. So let's jump in with the cards and see what else needs to come through in the energies today. I just peeked and saw the Nine of Pentacles. Perhaps there was a missed opportunity when it comes to a deep, deep loving connection. This is like the Holy Grail, right? And it always begins with self. Everything is always an inside job. So there's without a doubt a conscious release here. A long-standing burden, maybe a coming to Jesus, coming to your knees moment. There's a need to release a burden, maybe when it comes to a missed opportunity in love. So let's do a nine card spread, guys, and see what else needs to come through in the energies today. It's time to bury the past. I do feel it's time to bury the past so we can move on into these new collaborative cycles. So let's do nine cards and see what needs to come through. Four of Swords reversed. Knight of Pentacles reversed. King of Wands. Fire energy, Virgo energy. We get the Nine of Pentacles. The Hermit. The Ten of Wands in reversed. So I feel somebody has been in deep contemplation since about Virgo season. We could be dealing with a Virgo here when it comes to closing out a karmic cycle, a big, big life lesson being learned. And we get the Two of Wands, which is very stuck energy, unwilling to make a decision. And then we get the Five of Cups in reverse. So there's a need to release something that's really weighed heavy for a long time, and maybe it's an ending. I feel there was an ending in the past with an Empress, a Divine Feminine, somebody here that is, you know, very strong. She's a mother. She's loving. She loves unconditionally, right? She gives without any expectations, but she also knows her worth and her value, right? She's not going to give to a situation that isn't returning to her. And so maybe there's going to be a breakdown. I feel there's likely an ending of a long-standing commitment, and I think maybe this Empress is making a decision. I feel there's been a lot of challenges. There's been a lot of power struggles, a lot of battles, and I feel this is definitely stemming around some Saturn energy. Saturn is about to station direct at the end of this week, and so I feel this is stemming around that. Somebody's really been struggling internally. Maybe there's a feminine here that's losing faith when it comes to a situation that's caused a lot of chaos, a lot of conflict, a lot of drama. Maybe a lot of outside opposing opinions have gotten in the mix, but I feel a feminine here stepping into her worth and her value. Very well could be a Taurus, very strong Taurus energy, and I feel this energy of the cat's out of the bag. Secrets are being revealed. Maybe somebody's received some poor advice when it comes to a brand new beginning in love. Maybe somebody's feeling like a sacred clown, right? Maybe somebody's afraid to take a leap of faith because it will require some disclosure of some secrets. The High Priestess upright is secrets. There's something coming to light. Secrets coming to the surface. There is going to be a reset here. Maybe this is going to lead to a job loss when it comes to somebody that's not been honest. There was lies here. There's not been, you know, a healthy communication here. There's likely been some blocked communication, and something is needing to be rebalanced. And I think something is getting illuminated. Maybe somebody is being enlightened. So this is what we got. In the past, we got the Four of Swords in reverse, the Knight of Coins in reverse, and the King of Wands. So what appears to be somebody very much in control, in charge of a situation, driven to take action, leadership energy, really wasn't investing, right? You know, came in with a lot of passion. The King of Wands is usually an older man, but when we get this Knight of Pentacles in reversed, I feel they really weren't coming in with a solid offer. It was an illusion of some sort. And I also feel this energy of needing to heal, needing to accept some truth before things get worse. And so I feel there was like a missed opportunity to maybe invest because somebody was a little bit immature. Although they seemed ready to take action, I think they were a little bit immature. There very well could have been a cheating scenario in the past. The Knight of Coins in reverse is not loyal, is not dedicated. Could be planting seeds all over town. And I feel there is a need to acknowledge this before things get worse. So what we got going on currently is this Nine of Pentacles. So pre-Empress energy, we get the Hermit and the Ten of Wands in reversed. And so I kind of feel a feminine here that's really going within right now. Somebody here that I feel maybe is single at the moment. Somebody here that I feel is, you know, connected to her spiritual team, her spiritual guidance, very heart-centered. I feel if there's been some recent truth spoken, it was spoken from the heart, even if it was harsh. And I feel a pre-empress here could be dealing with a Virgo, very much standing in her feminine power. I feel maybe pulling the plug on a situation where she's prayed and prayed and prayed for things to change and there's been no progress. Maybe a Leo. And I feel this is the energy here of Hermit, right? This is a timing card. So we're really not getting timing on anything right now. And so I feel this is a matter of going within and digesting, doing the work of a conscious release of a past burden. Maybe of a King of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sag. I feel there's a need to allow a cycle to come to a complete close. So could be dealing with one of the fixed signs, although all of the fixed energies, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, and Aquarius are really going to be in the thick of it with this eclipse energy. It's deeply affecting all of the fixed sign placements. But if you look at this, when this lesson is mastered, in the center is that new beginning, right? And so I feel this energy of the rug getting pulled from under somebody. And I think there's been a lot of emotional struggles. I think somebody's really struggled with releasing a situation here because there was love at one point in time, I think. And at least at the Empress's point of view, she had love for this person, right? She gave it her all. I also feel she's losing faith, though, that maybe this King of Wands isn't going to do what he needs to do to take action to maybe release a burden. Maybe this King of Wands now is sitting in a whole whack load of grief, needing to release some guilt and shame about some secrets that need to come out before a leap of faith can be given. I feel somebody really wasn't able to invest in this before because they were not being honest with themselves. So let's dig a little bit further into this Knight of Coins reversed King of Wands. That one really wanted to come out. We get the Knight of Wands reversed, the Nine of Wands, and the Five of Coins in reversed. And so I feel somebody in the past, you know, I hate to say it, was like a loser. I feel somebody in the past didn't have what it took to do the right thing. And I feel they were very inconsistent. They were wearing a mask. They were pretending to be, you know, this really strong, confident energy. And I think maybe they lacked self-control and they lacked self-worth. And so maybe they chose to have affairs to go after that outside validation for an ego boost. But I also feel somebody here that maybe abandoned this Empress in her time of need and really wasn't there for her, now wanting to come in and heal this abandonment, really learning a lesson about commitment is what I'm feeling, about commitment. And so I feel somebody's really been struck in the heart, and maybe they've deeply hurt the person that they love the most. And I don't think there's been a lot of open communication about this. And there is a need to heal a situation where I feel there was no victory. Somebody had their walls up. They were guarded. And maybe this person is going through an emotional breakdown, coming to terms with the fact that they kind of like did not invest in a connection that was their perfect match. They were not grounded. They were not stable. They really didn't have a pot to piss in. So what are they going to bring forward, right? There was passion here. Absolutely. Absolutely. And I feel maybe it's kind of time to heal. To heal this connection, a healing love is trying to come in. So let's take a look at this burden, this Ten of Wands reversed, because it can't be consciously released unless it's kind of talked about. And so definitely some cheating, some lying, some cheating, some thieving. There's likely going to be a confession because somebody was dancing with the devil. They were playing into toxic behaviors, extremely codependent. There could have been addictions here for sure, without a doubt. And they're breaking these chains, choosing to walk away from a very toxic situation. And so I think there is going to be a confession of some sort. Maybe you were dealing with a Capricorn or a Pisces, but somebody is definitely getting schooled by Saturn, about to turn direct. And I feel they were caged. They were caged and trapped. Somebody's definitely feeling foolish. There is a need to break free from addictions before things get worse. Somebody has really not wanted to embrace the healing journey, but they're walking away from something toxic. They're getting ready to make peace with this past emotional baggage and to walk the path, and they're going straight towards wish fulfillment. After a period of confusion, I feel maybe this person's confession is, hey, I had a lot of options on the go. I think there was maybe a lot of different cups being played with, and somebody is without a doubt feeling foolish. And I think maybe they're worried this person isn't going to want to put in the work. So let's see what this Nine of Coins has to say, pre-Empress energy. I think she's saying, nah, dude. You had your opportunity. I've lost passion for this situation. I've lost passion for this situation. I feel a nine of coins here that has built a solid foundation for herself, or she's about to. She's about to communicate. I have everything I need. I don't need you for anything. I'm at the nine. I know what I deserve. I'm going after what I deserve. And I feel the answer is no. I don't think there is going to be a reconciliation here. I think this pre-Empress is looking at this as a bad judgment call, and I feel there's not going to be an opportunity for a reconciliation. We're not going to be able to rebuild here. I feel somebody's breaking free from an illusion. At one point in time, I think this pre-Empress thought that this was going to be a legacy for her future, for her family. And I feel she's learning her worth and her value. And I think she's choosing to be single, to really go within. So this can be released once and for all. So this bondage, this trauma bond, can be broken. Taking those steps to go after what it is she knows that she deserves. I feel an ending. I feel she's lost faith in this person. So let's take a look at the Five of Cups reversed. There's going to be an unavoidable shakeup. And you're not going to be able to avoid this. And I feel maybe this will bring in somebody new. There's going to be a need to release an extended period of grieving. I feel somebody has really allowed themselves to stay stuck at the crossroad when it comes to completing a karmic cycle, mastering a karmic lesson, and I feel time's up. So I feel it's really time to go within and invest in, you know, people that will be loyal to you too. So I feel somebody's really stayed stuck for a long time thinking about communicating this truth. I feel there is going to be a new offer coming in. Maybe there's going to be a revelation or a child speaking up that's going to get the ball moving in a new direction. But then we get this King of Cups and this Six of Cups. I kind of feel a very toxic situation needs to be released. And at one point in time, I think you thought this was your person. And maybe you were a perfect match at one point in time. But I feel somebody grew and the other person stayed stuck and didn't really grow into the relationship. And I feel once this is released, there is likely going to be a new exciting opportunity coming in with somebody that is emotionally mature, that you will feel like a child with again. And this could be a past life reunion. Somebody wants to come in with a very emotional offer, maybe a Scorpio, I'm not sure, but I feel there's some challenges to overcome before this brand new beginning in love can come in. So I feel there is a need to release a dramatic situation without a doubt. And this is coming in very quickly. Somebody is making a final judgment call. And I feel there is some karma playing out in the energies today. So I want to read into the book when it comes to the Pallas Athena energy and the Virgo energy, and then we're going to get some closing messages, guys. So we're going to read into this. This is feeling pretty heavy. And so I feel somebody is very sharp and guarded, absolutely. So this card came out, I feel, to loan somebody the ability to take on this very challenging situation, to completely stand in their power and to find the right words at hand. So I feel somebody is on the spectrum here when it comes to either making a decision or not. I feel a divine feminine here has been very much disrespected and denied. And I feel she is coming to a place of completion. There is a divine feminine receiving the answer she needs when it comes to somebody that's been wearing a mask that is about to reveal their true self. So it's going to take logic, and I do feel it's going to bring forward a lot of truth, and it's going to require an open heart because I do feel digesting something very difficult in the energy. So we're going to read into the Virgo energy, and so yeah, somebody is weeding out their garden. Get ready to pull those weeds out, because if you don't, you cannot plant for the future and cultivate this solid foundation. And so somebody is re-evaluating their co-creating abilities. That's what the Empress does, right? She's a creator. And so something needs to be cleaned up in order to break these chains and to enter into a new creative process flow. So I feel something is incomplete when it comes to a complex connection here. I don't think it really fit well together when you looked at the finer details. And so there's a lot of shadow energy coming up when it comes to a false foundation. And I think somebody really didn't know their worth in the past. And now they're paying attention, piecing it all back together and realizing that it's time to grow through this very, very difficult situation. And I don't think it's going to be easy to digest this, because what your mind perceived as what was yours is not what your heart and your soul has planned for you. So I do feel there's going to be a wake-up call, and I feel an Empress that is giving up a situation that she really fought a long time for, that I feel she had faith in the future, and now she's just realizing this is hopeless, this is over, I'm all done with this power struggle, I want to expand beyond this, I know my worth, I know my value, I'm going to heal my heart, I'm going to give birth to this new creative energy, and I'm going to sit on my throne, and I'm going to know my worth and my value, and I'm not going to go chasing anybody down. You know where to find me, and I'm going to attract in my life what it is that I need. And I feel an Empress here that's all done with third-party drama. And maybe this is going to feel like a huge missed opportunity, but I feel this is going to activate somebody's life force energy in order to create the life of their dreams. So let's get a last closing message. I think I'm going to grab, we're going to grab the Rose Oracle message because there is a Divine Feminine coming through. So let's get a closing message. I feel maybe this Empress is going to have a lot of offers coming in once she stands in her worth and her value. And so there's going to be a lot of heart healing here. A lot of emotions coming to the surface. And there is the possibility of a reunion. Maybe from a past life soulmate that you haven't even met yet. But I feel collaboration is in focus. Partnerships are in focus. And somebody here has been moved by this goddess is what I'm feeling. And somebody has heard her soul's call. And I want to say, after the rain comes the rainbow. I think we're finally about to see the silver lining. We're reaching a place on the journey of having mercy. So there is definitely something that is over. It will require acceptance in order to bring forward a reunion with a past life soulmate. And you will recognize this person right away by their vibrations and the energy that they carry. And this will be a heart healing connection. And so the blueprint is in you. I feel somebody's been planted and they've been in the dark night of the soul. And now it's time to take those next steps forward into the light. The seeds have already been planted. And I feel the energy of ease is coming. And time eases all of these burdens, right? So mercy, hope, relief. Somebody is being called by their soul to honor their inner mystic and to live consciously and courageously and to understand that there is clarity coming. There is a fresh new start here and there is a positive new outlook. So release what needs to die away. It was never built on solid ground in the first place. It was never meant to last. And maybe it was put on your path in order for you to shift your internal beliefs, to know your worth and your value. And that's kind of what I got for a message today, guys. I hope this helped. I hope this resonated. If you would like to book a personal or a soulmate reading, check out the description box below. I look forward to finishing the new moon solar eclipse readings for the rest of the signs. So keep an eye out for that. And I do look forward to seeing you all again next time. Thank you.